friends, Ryan Lestrange here with a Monday word, and my Monday word for you is take authority over negative emotional climates. Over negative emotional climates. Romans 8 and verse 6 in the Amplified says, now let this mind of the let this mind be in you. I'm sorry, that's Philippians 2:5. Let this mind be in you, which was in Christ Jesus. Romans 8, 6 says, now the mind of the flesh is death, both now and forever, because it pursues sin. But the mind of the Spirit is life and peace, the spiritual well-being that comes from walking with God, both now and forever. So he's telling us here that we are to let this mind be in us, which is in Christ Jesus. The mind of Christ is not confused. The mind of Christ is not critical. The mind of Christ is not full of complaint. The mind of Christ is not double-minded, vacillating between conviction and roaming. The mind of Christ is not going between promise and problem. The mind of Christ is not going between salvation and curses, but the mind of Christ is solidified in the reality of the Lordship of Jesus. The mind of Christ is solidified in the reality of the thoughts of God. And then in Romans 8, 6, it said, the mind of the flesh is death. As long as you continue to subdue your spirit with carnal thinking and only going after the wisdom of man, you are going to have these negative emotional climates. I know people that say, well, I've read every blog about this and it just says I've got this problem. Well, all of that information may be valuable. There is another pathway that is so powerful, and that is the mind of the spirit. He said the mind of the spirit is life and peace. When I tap into the mind of God, I walk out of all my past thought patterns. The thought patterns that said you're always going to stay broke. You're always going to stay in this calamity. You're always going to stay in this situation. No, I'm empowered to literally walk out of those thought patterns. How? Through the mind of the Spirit. Let me tell you something. This is the reality. Without a renewed mind, without a mind that is rooted in the Word of God, that you begin to define yourself the way the Word of God defines you, and you begin to study and pray and meditate the Word of God, you're going to stay stuck in cycles of bondage. Wrong thinking creates cycles of bondage, that there's repetitious cycles. Because the reality is this: thoughts produce attitudes, attitudes create climates, and climates manifest behaviors. So a lot of us are stuck in negative climates, because our inner thought is guiding our life. If my inner thought is, you know what, I'm always going to fail. It doesn't matter how many scriptures I get on redemption and success. If I don't renew my mind and I don't get the word of the Lord and I don't begin to think the way Jesus thinks, how do I find how Jesus thinks in the word? The Bible said, in the beginning was the word was with God, and the word was God. Then I'm going to continue to create this climate around me. We reproduce externally what we are experiencing internally. So when we're experiencing crisis and conflict on a consistent basis internally, we are reproducing that externally. And therefore, we get duped through carnal thinking into thinking our main problem is external. So we think, if I get a different job, I'm going to feel better, but we don't. If I get a different spouse, I'm going to feel better, but we don't. If I get in a different relationship, I'm going to feel better. If I go to another city, I'm going to feel better. While those things could hold merit depending on the particular situation, the reality is oftentimes we are simply recreating or replicating what's inside of us. So how do we change it? We begin to change the way we think. It begins with a process of saying, I'm going to learn to think like Jesus. There's only one way. I've got to get into the Word. I've got to study the thoughts and the ways and the principles of Jesus. And then it cannot just be conceptual. It has to be reality to me. I've got to pray over those things. I've got to meditate. One word to meditate is to mutter. It means to speak softly, repetitiously. It's like digesting the scripture. It's reading a verse and pausing and reading again and pausing and reading again and pausing until it gets in you. I really believe Jesus wants to help you break those negative climates that you've become so accustomed to. And it begins by taking authority over thought patterns and processes. We focus so much on deliverance, casting something out, and that's a vital part of it. But we don't focus on putting something in. And so people can go through a pattern of cast out, cast out, cast out. But there's never real reformation because they don't learn to think differently. If you learn to think differently, you will live differently. So, Father, I pray today, let this mind be in us, which was in Christ Jesus. Let this be an aggressive command in our lives, that we would radically pursue the thoughts of Jesus, the peace of Jesus, the core values of Jesus, the principles of Jesus. And we know that your word is our spirit and their life. So the words themselves have the potential to heal us. And I thank you for it now, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.